what it was, quietly unfolding right in front of us. Words and tales from storybooks can't compare, they're not as good. Looking at you now, it's obvious, it's meant to be. Try, it comes naturally. There's just no denying when stars align, perfect harmony. Turns out it's better than make believe. But I don't need to write it. I knew you were right for me. Chest, recite it like a heartbeat if ever I forget. Words and tales from storybooks can't compare, they're not as good. Looking at you now, it's obvious, it's meant to be. Don't have to try, it comes naturally. Just no denying when stars align, perfect harmony. Turns out it's better than make believe. But I don't need to write it. I knew you were right for me. For me. There's no denying I knew you were right for me. For me. But I don't need to write it. I knew you were right for me.
Dangerous plan, just in time. The stranger's hand clutched in mine. I take this chance, so call me blind. I've been waiting all my life. Please don't scar this young heart. Just take my hand. And I was made for loving you. Even though we may be hopeless hearts just passing through. Every bone screaming, I don't know what we should do. Oh, no, no, darling, I was made for loving you. Hold me close through the night. Don't let go. We'll be alright. touch my soul and hold it tight. I'll be waiting all my life. I won't scar your young heart. Just take my hand. And I was made for loving you. Even though we may be hopeless hearts, it's passing through. And I don't know what we should do. Oh, darling, I was made for loving you. And I was made for loving you. Oh, I was made for loving you. I was made for loving you. And I was made for loving you.
Grab a seat, everyone. Grab a seat. That's how you do it. Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We are gathered here today to celebrate the coming together of two very special people. My name is David Lang, and I have the absolute honor and privilege to marry these two lovebirds today, Jordan and Dennis. I'm sure you agree that we couldn't have asked for a more beautiful setting than the one we have right here at Athol Hall in Mossman. They are honored that all of you, their closest family and friends, are here to share this joyous and truly special occasion, and are extremely thankful for those who have traveled great distances to be present here today. And hello to everyone watching on live stream. Hope you're enjoying watching the live stream.
Welcome.
Well, it's been 3 years since these two first got together, with their first kiss taking place at everyone's favorite romantic location, their work Christmas party back in December of 2020. But let's fast forward to the proposal. It was Den who proposed at Jordan's favorite vineyard in the Hunter Valley in December of 2022. They had a beautiful picnic overlooking the property when he popped the question. Unfortunately for both him and us, Jordan said yes, and here we are today. When I asked them why they wanted to get married to each other, Jordan said it was an easy decision to make. From the beginning, being with him has felt so easy, and picturing a future together has always felt so natural and right. He's an absolute joy to know and love, she said. Dennis knew Jordan was the one because every time he looked at her, she made him smile, and he felt like a part of him was missing when they were apart. Oh. I realized early on that she was someone who could make me happy, and I, in return, she would make me happy for our whole lives. She would be my best friend as long as we live. She loves me for me and accepts me without trying to change me, except maybe my dress sense. I feel she makes me a better version of myself every day, and I couldn't imagine my life without her. Speaking of being happy, one of the things Jordan loves the most about Dennis is that he makes her laugh every day. The longer we're together, the sillier and less seriously he takes himself, which just makes my heart so happy. He is so unbelievably kind and generous, and I feel like anyone can see that so clearly in his gorgeous face and his beautiful warm smile. He is my biggest supporter and loudest advocate, and I'm so proud to be his partner. For Dennis, it's how kind, honest, and genuine Jordan is. We don't need to keep anything from each other because we trust each other so much. She is a genuine beauty inside and out. And when she smiles, it really lights up a room. She always has an open mind and loves me regardless of my opinions and flaws. Bonus is, she's also a great cook. So, yeah, well done. Our kids are hopefully a part of their future together. In fact, Jordan said picturing Dennis as a dad couldn't be easier. The way he is with his nieces and nephews, friends and families, children, and really any baby he meets is the cutest thing I've ever seen. He was born to be a dad, and I can't wait until the day that happens. And Dennis knows that Jordan will make the most loving and supportive mother, who will dedicate herself to her children in the most loving and profound way, never letting them want for anything, and being there for them no matter what they think, believe, or how they express themselves. She will be truly the rock they need for their entire lives, he said. So, whether it's some playful banter with each other's expense, the time Jordan watched Dennis swear in both Spanish and English as a huntsman crawled up his neck in Jordan's old ute, Jordan's non-stop giggling when she finds something hilarious, or Dennis putting on a fake British accent when using his phone voice. It's clear from my meetings with you both that you are meant to be and can clearly handle anything life can throw at you, and I couldn't be happier for the two of you. All right, it's now time for some readings. If I could please ask Eleanor, Lottie, and Summer to come up and say some readings. Come on down. Hey, guys.
Thank you. So we're just going to start with a reading and a blessing for the two of you. So this is from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 13. Though I command languages both human and angelic, if I speak without love, I am no more than a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. And though I have the power of prophecy to penetrate all mysteries and knowledge, and though I have all faith necessary to move mountains, if I am without love, I am nothing. Though I should give away to the poor all that I possess and even give up my body to be burned, if I am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. Love is never jealous. Love is not boastful or conceited. It is never rude and never seeks its own advantage. It does not take offense or store up grievances. Love does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but finds its joy in the truth. It is always ready to make allowances, to trust, to hope. Love never comes to an end. But if there are prophecies, they will be done away with. If tongues, they will fall silent. And if knowledge, it will be done away with. For we know only imperfectly, and we prophesy imperfectly. But once perfection comes, all imperfect things will be done away with.
Okay. In a land where love always blooms bright, Jordan and Dennis, what a perfect sight. Two vets united, a love so true, wishing you laughter and everything new. With tails of fur and feathers in flight, may your days be happy and always bright. From puppy kisses to kitten purrs, take turns in giving what the other prefers.
As you say I do in vows so sweet, may your marriage be a love so complete, like a cozy blanket, warm and tight, may your love grow with each starry night. To Jordan and Dennis, a toast we raise. May you navigate with love through life's maze. Here's to joy, to pets, to wedded cheer, a happy life together year after year.
Well done, guys. Thank you so much. Resume the position. All right. Thanks, guys. It is now time for the legal wording. So, Jordan and Dennis, have you come here today voluntarily to be joined in this marriage? We have. Oh, that was two yeses, everyone, just so you know, it's good. I, David Lang, am duly authorized by law to solemnize marriages according to law. Now, before you are joined in marriage, in my presence, and in the presence of these witnesses, I'm to remind you of the solemn and binding nature of the relationship that you are now about to enter. Marriage, according to the law in Australia, is the union of two people to the exclusion of all others voluntarily entered into for life. So, Dan.
Please repeat after me. I call upon
the persons here present
to witness that I
Dennis John Hitchin
take you Jordan Hewitt Blackband
to be my lawful wedded wife.
After me. I call upon
the persons here present
to witness that I
Jordan Hewitt Blackband
take you Dennis John Hitchin
to be my lawful wedded husband.
All right, it's now time for their own vows, so let me just get there.
Den, our day is finally here, and I could not be happier to be standing here with you about to become your wife. It's hard to put into words just how incredible you are. You are so unbelievably kind and generous, not only to your closest people, but everyone around you. I can't tell you how many old ladies at the vet clinic I thought I'd have to fight off. Your lovely, gentle way with not only our pets, but with all animals, makes you better and more handsome than any Bondi vet, in my opinion. Getting married wasn't always something I was certain of, but meeting you, falling in love, building a beautiful life together over the last 3 years, I became certain that this was the life for me. I love the way we navigate this adventure together, finding joy in our similarities and celebrating our differences, always open to growing and maturing together. Life certainly loves to throw a few curveballs, and we've definitely had a few shake us over the last year. Through the chaos of this recent chapter, you've been such an unwavering pillar of strength and support. Thank you. It does break my heart a little to know I'll never get to meet your dad in person, but the man I've come to know through your memories is a pretty spectacular guy. I know he would be looking down on us today and bursting with pride at the boy you were and the man that you are before me today. And I want to make a few promises to you now. I promise to listen to you. I'm not sure I'll always take your advice, but you will always feel heard. I promise to be honest and also to trust in you and in us. I promise to always be your dance partner, today for the first time as your wife, and in the many years to come in our kitchen till we're old and grey. I promise that marriage won't always be easy, but I will be with you and I will love you through it all. Every struggle and every triumph that we face, we do it together. Te amo y amare toda la vida.
Well done. You can give that a round of applause, guys. That was beautiful. Well done.
Hard one. My dearest Jordan, my Geordie, Jords, the many names I give you, you are truly the love of my life. To say you're my best friend, just, it's not enough. There are no words to describe what you mean to me. I thank God every day for bringing you into my life. The love I feel for you is just so rich, so deep, that my cup just overflows whenever I'm with you. I'm just lost when we're not together. You are genuinely one of the greatest people in my life, and you inspire me to be the best version of myself. I can see us growing old together. I can see us 50 years from now, just holding hands, still very much in love, and unbreakable in our commitment to each other. I profess to you with all my heart and my mind that I will honor, love, support, cherish you all the days of my life. I will love you in sickness as in health, for better, for worse, poverty, wealth, doesn't matter. I will be true to you no matter what, and I'll be faithful until my dying breath. I promise that I'm going to be so open to children with you. And together we're just going to raise them as a beautiful reflection of who we are. I will never leave you wanting. You are my world. I give you my heart openly and freely as I ask you to be my wife.
Yes, yes. I'm not real.
Oh, well done, guys.
All right. It is now time for the rings. So if I could please ask our ring bearers, Jordan's sisters Lottie and Summer, to come on up with the rings. The giving of the rings is an almost universal symbol of marriage and one that is common in many cultures. In just about all of them, the unbroken symbol of the wedding band, which is given to be worn permanently, is a symbol of wholeness, strength, and love, which has no beginning and no ending. So.
Amazing. No, all good. Okay, I need to take the other person's ring for me. Cool. That's it. Thanks, guys.
Awesome.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so.
Here we go. Yeah, beautiful.
So, Dan, I'm going to get you to repeat after me. Hold this one.
Jordan.
Jordan.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my everlasting love for you.
As a symbol of my everlasting love for you.
I offer you all that I have.
I offer you all that I have.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I will be.
And all that I will be.
Beautiful. Okay, hold on. All right, John. Who's it read off of me? Dennis.
Dennis.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my everlasting love for you.
Of my everlasting love for you.
I offer you all that I have.
I offer you all that I have.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I will be.
And all that I will be.
By the power vested in me, it is my absolute pleasure to pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride! All right, now, Jordan and Dennis have asked Melinda and Gladys to be their wonderful mothers, to be their witnesses for today's ceremony. So we're going to go over here. We're going to sign some very important documents. We'll be back in just a minute. Thanks, everyone.
I call you when I need you, my heart's on fire. You come to me wild and wild. You come to me. Give me everything I need. Give me a lifetime of promises and a world of dreams. Speak the language of love, know what it means. I can't be wrong. Take my heart and make it strong. It's simply the best. Better than all the rest. Better than anyone I ever met. You're stuck in my heart. Hang on every word you say. Tear us apart. Baby, I would rather be there. Rather be dead. Your heart is see the start of every night and every day. In your eyes I get lost and washed away. Just as long as you're here with me, arms could be no better place. You're simply the best. Better than all the rest. Better than anyone I ever met. You're stuck on my heart. Hang every word you say. could tear us apart. Baby, I would rather, I'd rather be dead.
Jordan and Dennis, may you love deeply, laugh heartily, practice patience, and smile often. May you dream together, grow, be crazy and daring, give and give in, and trust enough to take. May you see many sunrises, listen to the rain, savor special moments, and rediscover each other over and over and over again. And finally, when I asked them what the future holds for them both, Dennis said, one of the most profound partnerships that you could hope for, with love and respect always present, and a loving family to support and love with all our hearts. And Jordan said, laughs every day, a home full of love, hopefully children, always dogs and cats, dancing with my best friend in the kitchen, and never-ending adventures. And I couldn't have said it better myself. With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you the brand new happily married couple, it's Dennis and Jordan!
Like a fool, I went stay too long. Now I wonder if your love's still strong. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, living, I'm yours.
Make some noise, guys, I just got married, come on!
Then the time I went to say goodbye. Now I'm back, not ashamed to cry. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, living, I'm yours.
All of my faults and the wounds that I carry. having said that, let's get this party started. Can you make some noise, please, ladies and gents? Presenting our bridal party, it is Sam Horner and Aaron Telfer. Next up is Nick Lavender and Jasmine Raya.
Put my faith in worship, but then my chance to get to heaven slay.
Here comes Aaron Papp and Lauren Cryer
about the future, but then I threw my caution to the wind. I have no reason to be carefree. No, no, no.
Next up is Andrew Blanchard and Caitlin Machado.
You know I heard that boogie rhythm. Hey, I have no choice but to get down, 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 down.
And ladies and gentlemen, the reason we are all here tonight, will you please get up on your feet for our brand new married couple,
Victoria and Tyler! I see the lightning. I know this anger is heaven sent. So I've got to hang out on my hang-ups, cause on the boogie I feel so hell-bent. Hey, hey. It's just an instant gut reaction that I get. I know I've never ever felt like this before. I don't know what to do, but then that's nothing new. Stuck between hell and hot water, I need a cure.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, whilst you're enjoying your delicious entrees, we're actually going to kick off our first round of speeches for the evening. I know, get excited, here we go. So, will you please all put your hands together for our mother of the groom, Gladys Hitchin, everybody. You can keep it going. She's not even up here. There, Gladys Hitchin, everybody. Come on down. Thank you. Thanks, Gladys. Hi.
Thank you.
No worries. Thanks.
Thank you very much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is my greatest happiness to accompany my youngest son, Dennis Jr., on this momentous occasion of his wedding day, to the love of his life. As a mother, your greatest hope is for the happiness of your child. Today, as they commit to each other, I feel confident that Dennis Jr. and Jordan will build a great home in which their love will grow day by day. Built on trust and respect, support and understanding, a love which will be the guidance for the upbringing of their wonderful and caring children to come. I am very proud of my son, and so was his father, Dennis Sr., who would have been thrilled to see his youngest son choosing to share the rest of his life with a young woman with all the wonderful qualities that Jordan possesses. Dennis will never fail you, Jordan. I am sure he brings his best to your marriage as he does to everything in his life. And I am sure that you will find an enormous support and confidence traveling through your life next to him. His sense of commitment is one of his gifts. And I am sure that his home will be his first priority. This will only be made stronger by you both being veterinarians, an area you both share a love for and will enrich your life together. I profoundly wish that my beloved husband, Dennis Sr., could have been here with us to enjoy this special moment in the life of our son. However, I am sure that his soul is here with us, blessing Dennis and Jordan. He used to say that the secret to a good marriage was when each of the two people were so preoccupied with trying to make the other person happy that they were too busy to worry about what they were receiving themselves. So our prayer for you both on your wedding day is that your life is full of love and joy as you constantly strive to make each other happy every single day. May the difficult times be rare and easily overcome. May all your collective dreams be realized as you continue to strive through life together. May you always remember to turn towards each other and never away, gaining a deep and lasting understanding and appreciation of each other's true love, true self. And may you fall in love over and over again for the rest of your life, knowing that the other will always be there to catch you. I love you very much, my son, and I embrace Jordan as a lovely daughter of mine, a new dearest member of the Hitchin family.
Thank you, Gladys. Such beautiful words. All right, we've heard from the mother of the groom. It's now time to hear from the father and mother of our amazing bride. Will Matthew and Melinda please come on up? Still coming, still coming. Oh, he's going first. There you go. Yeah, I believe so.
Oh, God.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. Thanks. For those who don't know me, my name is Matt. I'm Jordan's incredibly proud dad. Back when we had Geordie, Mel and I were very young, and so most of my growing up I did with Jord, and so Jord and I have a very special bond. So whatever I did, Geordie did, and that was from out of control skiing down black runs to jumping off waterfalls and even our ridiculous games of trying to make each other laugh by pulling horrendous faces. But despite all our adventures and my questionable sense of humour, Jordan somehow blossomed into a sensible, successful young woman. With her beautiful personality, her great sense of humour, she's attracted a whole bunch of amazing friends. And most importantly, she captivated the incredible Dennis, whom we all love and we welcome into our family. Meeting Dennis for the first time, I'll admit, I was very nervous. I even actually put on a collared shirt, which is actually a rare sight for me. But all that nervousness disappeared the moment he walked through the front door and he gave me a big Dennis bear hug. And just like that, Dennis felt like one of the family. And of course, the same is said for Dennis's wonderful mother, Gladys, his uncle Michael, his siblings Ellie, Charles, and their partners. I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge the support and the unconditional love provided by these special people who helped shape Jordan into the person she is today. Mel, Jordan's mum, her husband Murray, Craig, Jordan's grandparents, John and Viv, her uncle Matt, my parents, Catherine and Peter, my brother Paul, his wife Sophie, my wonderful wife Nick, and Jordan's two adoring sisters, Lottie and Summer. Finally, a quick thanks also to Dennis's best man, Andrew Blanchard, for organising a fantastic Bucks weekend. Well done, mate. So finally, Geordie and Dennis, here's to you guys. This is your day. May your lives be filled with laughter, adventure, and countless bear hugs. Now please, everyone, if you could raise your glasses with me to Jord and Den.
Okay. Stay with me. All right. I'm so proud to be standing here with you, my friend, 30 years later. We did not envisage how this part of the story would go as young parents, but here we are. Here we are. And when we started, we embarked on an extraordinary journey with our beautiful Geordie 30 years later. I cannot believe it. We've done this all the way with the love and support of our families. Mum, Dad, Peter, Kathy, my brother, Matt, and Paulie. Nick, Geordie's beautiful stepmum. Thank you for being such a gorgeous stepmother and advocate for my beautiful gal. And for Murray, for loving us as deeply as you do. There are a couple of very special people who are not here with us today in person, but I can definitely feel them here in spirit. We've felt them here all day with us, cheering Geordie and Dennis on as they have cheered us on our whole lives. My darling Dad, Johnny, and my dear Auntie Sue. We miss them, but their love and joy of life, particularly their joy for a good party, is imbued in us, and we must do them proud tonight. My auntie left this world saying, no moping, just celebration. And that's what we will do. Geordie, I could try and put into words our relationship, but I think all that know us know our bond, the love that I have for you. It is more than I could have ever hoped for, my darling, to live, grow, laugh, and witness each other's lives in the way that we do. It just makes my cup, as Den said in his vows, also fill over every single day. Toots, you are my heart. Dennis, I said to you at Christmas, what would the next phase of our life be and the next phase of our family? And I could not have ever imagined life without you. And I am just so happy you are part of our family. Thank you, darling. I love you. I am so happy for you both. I love you. And all I can now say is let's revel. Woo!
Excellent. Well done, guys. Thank you so much.
On a cloudy day, but when it's cold outside, I got the month of May. Said I guess you say, what can make me feel this way, my girl?
I got so much honey, babe. The bees, they envy me. I got the sweetest song, baby. Sweeter than the birds in the trees.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Hope you've all enjoyed your lovely mains. They certainly were amazing. Now, we're about to kick off our second round of speeches, ladies and gents, but before we do, I just thought, can we all give Jeff, our amazing drummer, a round of applause for removing our excellent bird earlier? Thank you, sir. Is Misty's calling working for wires? I'm not sure what happened there. Nice. All right, it is that time of the evening. We've heard from our parents of our bride and our groom. It is now time to hear from the bridal party. So I would like to invite Caitlin, our maid of honor, up to give us a speech, everybody. Whoa, it was, whoa. Someone was super excited.
Thank you. Oh my gosh, hello. I was very worried I'd have to do this with a turkey 2 meters above my head. First of all, what a beautiful wedding and a stunning bride. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Kate, and I first met Geordie through our mutual friend Gemma when we were bright-eyed and bushy-tailed in our first year of uni, and we started our journey towards vetting in 2013. We had an hour car ride to Camden in Gemma's car. And then I think I also fell in love with Geordie. So Dennis, I know how you feel. I learned that this girl was the coolest, funniest lady I'd ever met, and we just clicked. A few years into our friendship and one grueling undergraduate degree later, we finally made it into our veterinary science degree together. We thought, now we're in, it's gonna be a piece of cake, right? We spent more time at Frankie's and Shady Pines, our favorite Sydney bars, than our uni lectures. Those first semester postgraduate exams were a rude awakening and kicked us straight back into our StuVac cram sessions that should have been sponsored by Red Bull. One night, I won tickets to a concert at the State Theatre. Geordie and I studied for a little bit and we got a bit snacky, so we got into our housemates' brownies. It wasn't until we were sat down at the show that we realised there was something special about the brownies. Geordie said she couldn't feel her legs. During intermission, and some convincing that Geordie's legs were still attached to her body, she went on a bathroom break. But Jake Bug came back on stage and there was still no Geordie to be found. I went out to search for my friend, but it didn't take long. She was over with the security guard, chatting away and having a San Pellegrino on the house. She was okay, and we watched the rest of the show from the nosebleed section. Uni took us through many highs and lows, but it wasn't until both our living situations went up in flames that we decided to move in together. We moved into our cozy flat in North Sydney in early 2017. Where we enjoyed maybe one too many nights a week, traipsing around the city until morning, and then dragging each other to our uni practicals by 9 a.m. We loved living together so much that there was no other option but to move into our next house in Camden together, with an additional 2 ring-ins. Shout out to Loz and Mish. And they joined us in our wine and study sessions. But George, we've shared a lot of aspects of our life together. Studying, living together, being on the same sports teams, holidaying and even working together. But mostly there is no one else that I can trust to just be there for me. I think all people here today can attest to that as your character and how much you give to everybody in your life. Whether it's a movie marathon, snuggled on the couch, crying to our favorite song at a concert, or a glamorous and dignified Korean barbecue and karaoke session. You know, I'll always take another 3 demerit points for you. But fast forward many questionable phases of life and there appears Dennis. I first heard about Dennis as the handsome vet at her new job. That was so nice he'd even stay back and help her with after hours work. We all love a vet and vet love story. Seeing as the job is so romantic. So I'm gonna share the version I have in my head. So love was in the air, along with many pleasant odors of the veterinary clinic. Their two hands brushed upon another during an after-hours cesarean. And the next week, Geordie and Dennis were a couple. Okay, maybe there's more to the love story, but that's for another time. Come and talk to me later. Although I can't give you first-hand advice on a marriage, a wise woman recently gave me some inspiration. When it comes to the small stuff, shake it off. Don't go to bed with bad blood. Take the Christmas lights down whenever you want. And lastly, today was a fairy tale. May your love never go out of style. The end.
Awesome, awesome job. All right, we've heard from our maid of honor. It's now time to hear from the best man. Will you please put your hands together for Andrew, everybody?
Hi everyone. Oh, I just heard my own voice, that's weird. Well, it's been an amazing day. So I'm Andrew and I'm lucky to be the best man for Jordan and Dennis's best big day. Dennis, you're looking suave as ever, and Jordan, you look amazing. If I can say, the bridal party is looking stunning and the groom's party, we've done pretty well. So thank you. I feel like I've known Dennis for a lifetime. My earliest memories of our friendship started at school, where we were both in kindergarten at Our Lady of Nativity in Lawson. We would get dropped off early by each of our parents, where we would sit on these old green benches and we'd play. Early on, I saw just how generous Dennis was. He would often bring this big bag of marbles to school and he would invite me to play with them. And these old green benches, they were perfect for playing marbles. They had this little gap in between the slats, so we'd flick marbles at each other. I remember being very competitive about this daily game of marbles. And wanting to get better, I went to my dad and said, we need to get to school earlier because the teachers wanted me there. Little did my dad know, or Dennis know, it was so I could hone my marble skills against my nemesis, the marbles kid. I practiced and practiced, and then I started to notice that Dennis was getting in earlier. And I thought, ha, two can play at that game. So I asked my dad to drop me off even earlier. And the competition was fierce. Many a marble would get damaged and lost, most of them Dennis's. And we just kept turning up to school early, but eventually a school teacher saw these two lone kids playing marbles, and we got in trouble. It wasn't until years later that I brought up this memory with Dennis, and he told me he was only getting to school early because his dad had to get to work. So this marbles competition might have been in my head a little bit. But it was really just the foundation of our friendship, where we'd just push each other to do a little bit better each time. Our friendship continued to grow through the primary years and onto high school, where we would sit on the bus with it together each morning and afternoon. I remember Dennis used to save me a seat on the bus right behind the bus driver, and it was quite a mean feat to save this seat because I was the second last stop, so he had to fight tooth and nail against everyone. But these daily bus trips were really great because we'd talk less about handball each day and instead talk about the challenges with high school and offer advice. I remember one of our first tests in our friendship was when Dennis confided in me about his first crush. And he told me about his plan to declare his love with a letter. And he entrusted me with that letter. So I felt very honored to be his wingman. It was my first time. And in true high school fashion, I tracked this girl down and I saw her sitting in a circle with her friends. And I casually went up to her and pegged the letter at her. And then I ran off yelling, "Dennis likes you, see ya." And it worked. The dream team made it happen. Our friendship really grew from there, where we'd often champion each other in our pursuits and be there when each other had a fall. In high school, Dennis was very passionate about his grand goal to become a vet. He would pick subjects like advanced maths, agriculture, and other harder subjects that most students wouldn't do. Even in primary school, you could see how much Dennis loved animals. He would often tell me about the budgies he'd raised at home and how he would sell them to people in the local area. Even then, he was someone with a strong conviction and a desire to help. In year 12, Dennis became very focused on his goal, and he would spend almost all of his lunchtime studying in the school library. He was one of the few students who would actually go to study hall to study. And in the lead up to the HSC, he would be at Springwood Library almost every day. Really missing my friend, I used to pop in under the guise that I needed to study, but we'd end up chatting and mucking around and getting our fair share of shushes. Dennis was and still is very generous with his friendship, and he'll often carve out time, the little free time that he has. After school, our friendship continued, and we had many adventures where we went backpacking through South America for 6 weeks. Dennis was learning his beginner Spanish at the time, and he was really keen to practice it on the taxi drivers that we would meet. And he would often help us navigate the many airports that we would often get lost in. By the end of the trip, he was guiding taxi drivers on where to drive, and he was even translating from Spanish to English for some of the tourists we'd meet along the way. He always seemed to love helping people and challenging himself to learn new things. I remember we went on this day hike in Bariloche, this small town in Argentina, known as the Swiss Alps of South America. So we hiked up to the top of this big mountain, which was just covered in snow, and I was just admiring this view of this valley. So I just turned around to call Dennis over, and I just see him disappear off the edge of a cliff. So not really just panicking, I just ran over, and I saw him just sliding down this slope. So not sure what to do, I just went right down after him. So we're just sliding out, and I'm just freaking out of my mind. And then I hear Dennis just go, "Whee!" And then we landed softly on the snow. I get up scared and furious and run over to him yelling something like, "I thought you were falling, what were you doing?" And he just laughed at me and smiled, and he said he knew it was a small slope. So we climbed back up the hill again to take more photos, racing to see who could get to the top first. I'd love to share as many stories as I could about Dennis, but I'll save those for another time. I feel very honored that I'm able to tell you about my friendship with Dennis. It's a rare thing to see a bromance stand the test of time, from marble walls and kindy to being here where I am today. It's truly wonderful to see my best friend marry the love of his life. I remember when Dennis first met Jordan, he was quite mysterious about her. But slowly, he started talking more about how happy he was spending time with her. Over time, I saw my old friend become very adventurous. My friend who doesn't eat onion or capsicum was telling me about how he'd made tom yum soup with his new girlfriend, or how he'd tried fried tofu for the first time. Whereas the childhood friend I knew wouldn't have touched tofu with a 10-foot barge pole. I remember thinking that this girl must be quite special. And very soon he was raving about Jordan, talking about the interesting restaurants they would go to, their love of Japanese food, board game nights, and the long walks they'd take together. Now they have plans to travel the world, with their first stop being Japan, and then possibly onto Europe and beyond. I can't wait to see what adventures they go on. So please raise your glasses and wish them all the best together through life. All the best. Thank you.
Put your hands together for Andrew, everybody. Beautiful job. All right, ladies and gents, there's only one more speech left. Will you please put your hands together for our amazing groom, Jordan, everybody. Oh, Dennis, everybody, and Jordan. I got so hyped up to say both your names at the same time, I said Jordan's name first. Anyway, come on up, guys. Put your hands together for our brand new couple, ladies and gents.
That's so funny.
Jordan, there you go. Okay. It's a bit creased. What a night, eh? What a day. It's amazing in here. It's just such a beautiful thing to see you all together and just celebrating with us this amazing day. Now, I'd just really love to thank initially Andrew, Caitlin, and our wonderful parents and family for the wonderful speeches they've done. We were so touched by them all. And basically for all the help they've extended to us over the last 12 to 14 months since we've got engaged. They've just been a strength for all of us. Just the consistent love that they give us all the time just made the whole planning process so much easier. So I really want to thank you all so much for helping us. Now, I want to also give a really special thank you to my sister, who's made our wedding cake for tonight. It's beautiful. It's everything we wanted in a cake. Thank you, Ellie. Thank you so much. Now, we also want to give an amazing shout out to all our vendors, like the band, the stylists, everyone, all the photographers who've basically been with us for the whole day. And
special talent, bush turkey wrangling. That was a bonus.
That was amazing. I saw it through the window. Brilliant. Now, on a more serious note, there's three people who've passed in our lives in recent years. And they weren't here to celebrate with us tonight. We'd really love to acknowledge and pay respect to my dear father, Dad, Dennis Hitchin, Sr., Jordan's Poppy John Hewitt, and Jordan's great aunt, Susie. We all know you're here with us tonight. You've been with us the whole day, and we know that we have your blessing. You all helped us to make this a wonderful day because we know that you're with us in spirit. So we feel you here. Now, to all our dear guests, thank you all again so much for coming to celebrate with us tonight. You've all contributed something incredibly special to our lives in your own little way, and we wouldn't be who we are today without you all. We love you all so very much for being with us and just for being in our lives. I really want to give a giant shout out to a few special people who've traveled quite a long distance to be here tonight. My auntie Nemia promised me a fair few years ago, probably about 10, 12 years ago, that when I found the love of my life, and we had a really good DNM in the kitchen, when I found the love of my life, she would come to Australia and celebrate with us. And true to form, she's here tonight with us from Peru. So thank you so much, Auntie Nemia. I love you so much. Yeah. We'd also love to thank our dear friends Kate and Lou for coming from the UK. And also for my auntie Sue and uncle Anthony for coming from New Zealand. Now, there's many more of you who've come from such great distances, from regional areas in New South Wales and other states, and just from interstate. I mean, we can't thank you enough for being here with us. Like, it just means so much that you would put that effort in. So I really want to give a big thank you to all of you as well. Now, Jordan and I, we've been together for the last 3 years. Pretty amazing 3 years. We actually met, as you've already heard, at a small little vet practice in Albion Park. It only took us a couple of months to actually... yeah. Hey there. It's pretty special. I think I got paid for it as well. That was great. But no, it only took us a couple of months of just chatting at work and just spending a fair bit of time before we both kind of just started to fall for each other. And I mean, yeah, a fair few cesareans here, a couple of diarrhea cases later there. We really started to fall in love with each other. And that was it, basically. I mean, the Christmas party was just the start, but we basically just spent so much time together and found that we just knew each other in a way that I'd never known anyone else. And yeah, I guess here we
Me
are.
Too. Yeah. Ditto.
Peace out. Now, our relationship, it's just been based on trust, respect, and just an unwavering commitment to each other to always have fun and just laugh together daily. We've grown together in love, and I know we will continue that love every step of the way through this next chapter. Now, my beautiful, wonderful, and just loving wife, Jordan. I can actually call you my wife now. I love that. She's genuinely one of the most beautiful and amazing people I've ever met in my life. It's been one of the greatest pleasures of my life to... Oh, God. I always forget to breathe. It's been one of the greatest pleasures of my life getting to know you and the real you, not just the beautiful girl and the amazing personality inside of it. You are just endlessly likable. I don't think I know anyone who doesn't like you. I still can't believe how lucky I am that you fell in love with me. You make me want to be the best person I can be in just every part of my life. You take my breath away, literally. Just your smile, your laughs, your little quirks and kooky moments that you have with me. Every day is an adventure with you. And no matter what challenges we face in life, I know that it's going to be okay because we have each other. That's all we need. The laughs will never fade. And I know there is more to come that will endlessly fill our cup. Thank you for walking this life with me. My beautiful bride, my eternal heart. I want everyone to raise a glass to Jordan, the most beautiful bride in town. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Oh, you're good. Cool. You're sweet. You're good. Okay. Quick, another round of applause, please, for Jordan and Dennis, everybody. All right, everyone, I'm going to count down 3, 2, 1. I want you to make as much noise as you possibly can. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Cut the cake.
For a juvenile, but then if you're so smart, tell me why are you
awesome.
There we go. Oh. Yeah. There we go.
Slow down, you crazy nice. Child. Beautiful. You're so ambitious for a juvenile. But then if you're so smart, tell me why are you still so afraid?
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please put your hands together for our couple for their very first dance?
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. If I was a sculptor, but then again, no. Or a man who makes potions in a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. And you can tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down the words how wonderful life is while you're in. The moss, well, a few of the verses, well, they've got me quite cross. But the sun's been quite kind while I wrote this song. It's for people like you that keep it turned on. So excuse me for getting these things I do. You see, I've forgotten if they're green or they're blue. Anyway, the thing is, what I really mean, yours are the sweetest eyes I've ever seen. And you can tell everybody this is the song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in the words how wonderful life is while you're in. I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in the words how wonderful life is while you're in the world.
Oh, put your hands together, ladies and gents, that's how you do it. Well done. Hey, guess what, everyone? The dance floor is now open!
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. See, so
having a good time, having a good time.
I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go, 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 there's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky, yeah. 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling at the speed of light. I wanna make a
supersonic man out of you.
Good time.
Don't stop me now.
If you wanna have a good time.